Now, with me today in our studio is the distinguished broadcaster, Richard Dallin. We're here to talk about being a guest on a TV or radio programme and what do the media really want from people when they come to their studios. Richard is a seasoned journalist and a veteran of the media as a journalist and a presenter and a reporter. He's also one of our expert specialist tutors who hosts, you know, our media skills, media boosting confidence courses for us too. Welcome, Richard.
Thank you very much.
Good, good. Richard, first question, why do you think some very successful people in business shy away from speaking on the media?
I think they're frightened. I think they think we're out to get them in some way, that we're going to trip them up and that we're going to make them look fools. Whereas that isn't the case at all. What we want is a decent story. We've been told by our editor, our programme producer, whoever it is, to get a story. And so we get somebody on our programme and we hope that they're interesting. And if they're not, we've just got to make them interesting
but
somehow.
But the person there could be the story. Is that what they're afraid of?
It could be. And if they've got something to hide, then, you know, if it's in the public interest, it's up to us to make sure it comes out on television, on radio, whatever it might be. But by and large, people come on from industry, from business. They've got something to tell about what they do and what it involves and how people are affected by it. And all we're trying to do is to get them to say it. And sometimes our questions may seem a bit harsh, a bit direct, but we're prodding them a bit to speak and to be interesting. And if you don't go on a programme with something to say and be interesting, well, then you'll get a bit more prodding.
Well, because you say prodding, they may feel they're being kicked.
Oh, they may feel it, but we're not, as I said at the beginning, out to get them. We're out to make sure that they give the best of themselves. And I think some people can be a little bit hesitant. I would always advise people to rehearse what they're going to say a bit in advance. Know what your main point is going to be. Indeed, work out what you want to say. If you don't prepare when you're about to do a media interview, prepare to fail.
But what about those people who have the view that all journalists are bad people and that once they're on a programme that all you want to do is stuff words into their mouth and ask them leading questions? Is that true?
No, it's not true. And we're not all bad. Far from it. Most of us are simply inquisitors after the truth.
That sounds a bit people.
Curious people, indeed. We like to think we're asking questions that members of the public, people viewing or listening to the broadcast, will want to know the answer to. Believe it or not, and it is true, we do some research. We have people working with us as individual journalists. We will read the newspapers. We will know what is going on. We will know what is a current issue that needs to be put to an individual we have in front of us.
But some people would say that we are voyeurs on people's lives, and because of that, we ask them sometimes overly personal questions or questions that could be classed as unfair. Would that be true too?
Occasionally, we may ask questions that seem inappropriate, indelicate, but I would claim that we do ask questions that are appropriate of the people that we're asking them of.
So you don't have an idea that you want to get someone in there and make them look bad?
What is it for me to do that? I don't want to humiliate my guest. For one thing, other people will say, I'm not going on his programme. If every time that I appear on his programme, I'm going to get humiliated. There's no point in that. There comes a point where a viewer or a listener will say, stop going on at that poor woman, that poor man. You're being unfair to him. You're trying to grind him down. That isn't what it's about. What it's about is to bring out the best of people. And sometimes, okay, we prod them. We do not shove them. We don't do anything that's unreasonable. We just nudge them to an extent in a certain direction.